I knew she was trying to get certified.
She did.
She did.
Good for her.
She's going to start in September sometime. Well, she takes it.
Right. She should be a part of that firm. She's in the firm.
So I imagine one time it was a problem as well.
Nydia.
Mr. Bennett, my name is Nydia Tisdale, and I see a corporate logo on your site plan called Contracting Engineers Incorporated. I've got a few questions about the entity. Is that entity registered with the Secretary of State of Georgia to conduct business in the state of Georgia? And the second part of that question is that entity registered with the licensing board for professional engineers and land surveyors to perform professional engineering services in the state of Georgia? And I believe, sir, you served on that board at one time.
The answer is yes and yes.
And why is that information not available online on the Secretary of State website?
Maybe. I'm not sure.
And when was it registered?
I'm not sure.
So that corporate entity is registered and licensed to perform engineering services in the state of Georgia?
Yes.
And who is the professional engineer associated with Contracting Engineers Incorporated?
Me.
And you are currently licensed?
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, bye.
This water issue has a lot of, quote, forgive the pun, downstream implications. Mark already mentioned it. When these retention ponds fill, we have to pay to get them dredged, and that's hundreds of thousands of dollars. I recommend an escrow account so that these guys put some skin in the game, since they're going to be affecting our drainage, so that when it does come time, we're not footing the full bill.
Is there possible to do a bond on something like that?
No.
Yeah, Pulte did it.
I'll ask my engineer.
Pulte did it.
I'll ask her.
I mean, you. When I say no, I'm saying we would just develop it commercially before we would put it in an escrow account.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah. I think that's a great idea.
Yeah.
And think we'll do the commercial. Yeah. Because for another day.
Commercially, we still have the same detention requirements. It's basically the same, like we still drain into the same place. It's just more pavement. The commercial will have a lot more pavement than what these houses will. So it's, you mean this is very forgiving on pavement in impervious area compared to the commercial.
Joe, did you have another question?
I heard a couple of questions.
A second ago you said no. To the recent question, and you said, oh, well, we could. So the answer wasn't no, you just wouldn't do it. My question is, you said the two things that she mentioned, your guys were approved for the state and all that, you said, yes, they are. If it turns out they're not, would you agree you got to start over on this project?
Yes.
Okay. Why is your signature not on the site plan, and why is your professional engineer's stamp not on the site plan?
Just not required.
It's not required by whom?
UDC.
What about the state of Georgia?
It's not required by the state of Georgia. In fact, the state of Georgia, this is not a design plan. Engineer seals is all to do with design. That's how you get one. This is not a design plan. It's subject to design, and it's not required to be an engineered drawing.
It says site plan, sir.
It says it will not be an engineered drawing.
It
says
site
that
plan.
Specifically that it will not be an engineered drawing. That's in the UDC. So why would an engineer put his seal on a drawing that's not engineered?
So this drawing has not been engineered?
It's not required. This is a concept drawing subject to design. Yes.
Who drew the design? Who drew this drawing?
My company drew this drawing.
Your hand or whose hand? Who
Listen,
who prepared your drawing?
We're about to get way off base here.
That's a simple question. Who prepared the drawing?
Can I answer the question?
Yeah, he did.
Okay, we got another question.
He did.
I've answered every question.
We went through the same load of questions on a zoning issue bar. Ms. Tisdale brought this up in another zoning recently.
I think another three.
And the planning commissioner made a comment in a meeting specifically that said that it shall, but he kept ignoring the words et cetera.
Yes.
And in a meeting, I was concerned, so I clearly asked our director of planning and zoning if it's required at this stage, and he said no. Concept plan, sketch plan does not require it. I then turned in the open meeting to our legal counsel. I said, "Will you? Do you concur?" And he concurred. At this stage, it does not, because any zoning conditions that we ask to be changed or do get changed, however, will change how this gets ultimately landed. And they don't require that large expense at this stage or in the concept stage of discussions and molding and shaping a zoning for it to have be done at engineer level, and the stamp is not required until that stage. And once it gets past zoning, that just starts to go through all this extra scrutiny, additional scrutiny from all the departments, including the engineering, including the soil stuff, including the roads. All these things start to come into play. You will also find, maybe not in this, but in a lot of neighborhoods, once we give zonings for a certain amount of lots or a certain density, you will also find a lot of times they don't get the amount of lots they thought. One, because of topography. Two, because of additional state waters that are found, that weren't found. It gets much more into the deep weeds of finding things and much more detail after the zoning stage. It doesn't just fly through like this all the way to the end. It goes through all of our departments for a lot of scrutiny. Just to what happens, there are a lot of laws in the UDC that they have to follow, and state laws they have to follow that aren't on this paper at this time, because we already know they're set in stone in our laws and in our UDC. Our UDC is part of the county laws for zoning.
Okay.
If that helps understand any of that
at all. Okay, we have a question.
That's why it's a different section. You understand that?
My
section.